Hello, I am Dr. Rajitha. Welcome to Anatomy Channel. Today we shall study about external features of brainstem. So brainstem is the continuation of spinal cord above, and it continues above as the forebrain. So brainstem is a stalk-like structure which is connecting the spinal cord and the forebrain. Brainstem from below downwards, it is formed by the medulla oblongata, pons and midbrain. All three structures together called as brainstem. Coming to the features of medulla oblongata, what we are seeing is the ventral aspect of brainstem. Medulla oblongata is a bulb-like structure, which is a truncated cone-like structure. So bulbar paralysis, bulbar nuclei are the terms associated with medulla oblongata. And the length of the medulla oblongata approximately is of 3 cm. And width that its widest part is 2 cm and thickness is around 1.25 cm. And anteriorly, if we see the medulla oblongata, it is divided into two halves by means of a median fissure, which is called as anterior median fissure, which continues down as anterior median fissure of spinal cord. And anterior median fissure ends up here between the pons and medulla, forming foramen cecum, which is a blind groove. On the either side of the anterior median fissure, there are two longitudinal elevations which are present, which are called as pyramids. They are called as pyramids. Deep to pyramid, there are tracts called as pyramidal tracts. And lateral to pyramids, there is a sulcus here, which is called as anterolateral sulcus, and which separates the pyramid to an oval-like elevation present in the upper one-third of medulla oblongata. This oval-like elevation is called as olive. And deep to olive, there is a nucleus called as inferior olivary nucleus. And lateral most elevation is the inferior cerebellar peduncle, which connects the medulla oblongata to the cerebellum. Medulla consists of vital centers like respiratory center, cardiac center and vascular center. So any injury or compression of medulla oblongata is often fatal. And last four cranial nerves gets attached from the medulla. They get origin from the medulla. The last four cranial nerves are the 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th. 9th is the glossopharyngeal nerve. 10th is the vagus and 11th is spinal accessory. These three cranial nerves gets origin from the posterolateral sulcus, which separates the olive from inferior cerebellar peduncle. This groove is called as posterolateral sulcus, which separates the olive from inferior cerebellar peduncle. The rootlets of 9th glossopharyngeal, vagus and 11th, that is spinal accessory nerve. Coming to the anterolateral sulcus, the nerves rootlets are for the 12th cranial nerve, that is hypoglossal nerve. These rootlets joins to form hypoglossal nerve. The junction between the medulla and the pons is called as pontomedullary junction. From the pontomedullary junction, from medial to lateral, the nerves which are getting origin are the 6th cranial nerve, which is called as abducens nerve, and lateral to 6th, 7th cranial nerve, which is facial. Facial has got two roots, motor root and sensory root, is called as nervus intermedius. And lateral most, the nerve which is getting origin is the 8th cranial nerve, that is vestibulocochlear, which is also has got two parts, vestibular part and cochlear part. So three nerves are getting origin from pontomedullary junction. Let's see about the anterior surface of the pons. The pons, the other name it is called as bridge, because it connects the middle cerebellar peduncles. So on the either side, the pons continues with the middle cerebellar peduncles, which connects to the cerebellum. And pons anteriorly is striated by transverse striations. These striations are formed by the fibers called as pontocerebellar fibers, which travel towards the middle cerebellar peduncle. The most conspicuous feature over the pons is the groove which is present in the midline. This is called as basilar groove. There is an artery here called as basilar artery. The upper border of the pons separates it from the midbrain by means of crust. This is the crust cerebrae of the midbrain, which ends up with the upper border of the pons. The nerve which is getting origin from the pons is the fifth cranial nerve, that is the trigeminal nerve. Trigeminal nerve has got two parts, the smaller motor part and larger sensory part. And if we draw a vertical line lateral to this sensory part, it demarcates the pons from the middle cerebellar peduncle. And let's see about the midbrain. Midbrain is a small wedge-shaped structure. And coming to the crust cerebrae of the midbrain, which are the anterior features of the midbrain, and two cranial nerves gets origin from the midbrain. They are called as the third cranial nerve, oculomotor nerve, which gets origin on the medial side of the crust cerebrae and runs towards laterally. And next is the trochlear nerve. The trochlear nerve, the unique feature is it is the only nerve which is getting origin from the dorsal aspect of the brainstem. So after getting origin, it curls round the crust cerebrae and comes towards the ventral side of the brainstem. And in the gap between the two crust cerebrae is called as interpeduncular fossa. The dorsal surface of the brainstem, lower part is formed by the medulla oblongata. And if you see the medulla oblongata, it is again divided into two parts. Upper open part and lower half is called as the closed part. We can see the central canal of the spinal cord, which continues as the central canal of medulla oblongata. As it reaches the half of the medulla oblongata, the central canal gets opened up to form the floor of fourth ventricle. So the upper half of the medulla oblongata is called as open part and lower half is called as the closed part. And lower closed part has got a median sulcus, which is called posterior median sulcus, which divides posteriorly into two halves. The posterior median sulcus continues as posterior median sulcus of spinal cord. On the either side of the posterior median sulcus, there are three elevations, three tracks running up. This is the tract of Gall, that is fasciculus gracilis, fasciculus cuneatus, and lateral most is inferior cerebellar peduncle. Fasciculus gracilis, if it raises upwards, it ends up forming an elevation. Before forming the open part, it ends up forming an elevation called as gracile tubercle, deep to which there is a nucleus called as nucleus gracilis. And this is the lateral to this is the fasciculus cuneatus. Fasciculus cuneatus also ends up forming an elevation, forming a boundary of open part that is called as cuneate tubercle. And cuneate tubercle, deep to which there is a nucleus called as cuneate nucleus. Lateral most elevation is the inferior cerebellar peduncle, which connects to the cerebellum. And there is an elevation over the inferior cerebellar peduncle, which is called as tuber ciliarium. And this tuber ciliarium, deep to which there is a nucleus called as spinal nucleus of trigeminal nerve. And if we trace down, the spinal nucleus of trigeminal nerve continues as substantia gelatinosa of posterior horn of spinal cord. Next, we shall see the open part of medulla oblongata. The open part of medulla oblongata forms the floor of fourth ventricle, and it is demarcated by some important triangles called as hypoglossal triangle for 12th cranial nerve nuclei, vagal triangle, deep to which vagal nuclei are present, and lateral most is the vestibulocochlear area, deep to which vestibular and cochlear nuclei are present. And open half of the medulla is separated from the pons posteriorly by means of a faint fiber-like elevator terminalis. And let's see about the posterior part of the pons. The length of the pons is around 2.5 centimeters, and posteriorly it is demarcated by two rounded elevations which are called as facial colliculus, deep to which the facial tract is present and the nucleus is abducens nucleus or sixth cranial nerve nucleus is present. And laterally it is bounded by superior cerebellar peduncle and on the either side by middle cerebellar peduncle. And above is the midbrain. The midbrain is demarcated by four rounded bodies. These four rounded bodies are called as together corpora caudi gemina. And upper two rounded bodies are called superior colliculi and lower two rounded bodies are called as inferior colliculi. And the sulcus which separates these four bodies is called as cruciform sulcus. And if we trace laterally, the superior colliculi continues to form superior brachium and inferior colliculi continues to form inferior brachium. Brachium means arm-like. And the superior brachium ends up with lateral geniculate body, which is a part of optic pathway. And inferior brachium ends up with the medial geniculate body, which is a part of auditory pathway. So to remember, eyes are at a higher level, ears are at a lower level. So superior colliculi are concerned with vision, and so inferior colliculi and inferior brachium are concerned with hearing. And superiorly above, if we trace above to the midbrain, there is a body here which is called as pineal gland or pineal body, which is lodged in the groove above to the midbrain. And inferiorly, superior medullary vellum is connected to the inferior colliculi. And the nerve which is getting origin from the midbrain is the fourth cranial nerve, that is trochlear nerve, the only nerve which is getting origin from the dorsal aspect of the brain. After getting origin, they get crossover, and the crossed nerves will travel on the either side by winding round the crus cerebri. And so the length and the width of the midbrain is around 2.5 centimeters. This completes the external features. We shall continue with the spotters of brainstem. This is the specimen showing the anterior surface of brainstem. This is the lower cut part of midbrain. Down is the pons and lowermost is the medulla oblongata. Pons and the upper half of medulla oblongata are separated posteriorly from cerebellum by means of a cavity in between called as fourth ventricle. The specimen showing the pons and below medulla oblongata anteriorly, and we can see the two cerebellar hemispheres separated from the brainstem posteriorly. This is the posterior aspect of brainstem, where we can see posteriorly the four colliculi together called corpora caudi gemina of midbrain, and the floor of fourth ventricle formed by the pons, upper half of medulla and lower closed part of medulla oblongata. This is a specimen showing the medulla oblongata. The pointed structure here is the pyramid. The track deep to pyramid are the pyramidal tracts or corticospinal tracts. This is the olive, and nucleus deep to it is the inferior olivary nucleus. We can revise here again, this is pyramid, deep to it pyramidal tracts, olive, inferior olivary nucleus, and lateral most is the inferior cerebellar peduncle which connects to the cerebellum from medulla oblongata. Here the groove, this is the anterior surface of the pons showing the groove, which is called as basilar groove or basilar sulcus, and structure lodged here is the basilar artery. The pons laterally continues as middle cerebellar peduncle. The pinned structure here is the middle cerebellar peduncle, which is continuing on the either side with the cerebellum. This is the midbrain showing the four colliculi. Two are superior colliculi and the lower two are inferior colliculi. Superior colliculus continues to form superior brachium, and inferior colliculus continues laterally as inferior brachium. Upper open half of the medulla and posterior surface of the pons will form the floor of fourth ventricle. And floor of fourth ventricle would be discussed in my later sessions with the fourth ventricle. Thank you. Hope you all like my session. Please share, like, subscribe, and press the bell button for further notifications. Bye.